You might be familiar with the word oncology. Yes, you got it right. Oncology is linked to cancer. Basically, it is the field of study that deals with cancer, related treatments, and therapies. But do you know, apart from other complications, cancer treatments are impacting your heart? Are you thinking how? This is Earthy Perks, with a new episode to reveal an emerging field of interest, the cardio-oncology, and how it is impacting on the whole. As the name implies, cardio-oncology has everything to do with treatments related to cardiac issues. Be it detection, monitoring, or therapy, cardio-oncology keeps an eye on the side effects of cancer therapies on your heart. This goes for both radiotherapy and chemotherapy. With proven results, both of the treatments could result in cardiac dysfunction that acts as a significant factor of morbidity and mortality in cancer patients. Cancer patients should be monitored regularly for any prevailing cardiac issues. Patients on doses of anthracyclines and trastuzumab, monoclonal antibody, are on risk. A technique known as 3D echocardiography can help to calculate left ventricle ejection fraction and to detect any myocardial deformation. Various biomarkers, like natriuretic peptides, could act as early indicators for any potential cardiotoxicity. All this needs to be checked prior to initiating any cancer therapy, and it should be continued throughout the process. Why? Because cardiac dysfunction can occur even after years of getting those chemos and radios. The ones who are at high risk should be monitored by both, i.e. cardiologist and oncologist, for a detailed management plan. Now the question is when to stop taking cardiac treatment in case of dysfunction reversal, once the cancer therapy is completed. That needs time, of course. But for now, with efficient surveillance, two of the risk strategies are aligned, a primary and secondary one. It would help to minimize the risk of cardiovascular issues, impede the cardiotoxicities, and control the possible side effects. There are several factors that hurdle the process of reducing and preventing cancer therapy linked to cardiovascular incidents. Number one, lack of routine monitoring to check the cardiovascular risk. Number two, doctors and clinicians fail to evaluate any pre-existing cardiovascular risk prior to planning cancer therapy. Number three, the 2D echocardiography carries a low sensitivity to detect any potential cardiac damage. Number four, lack of knowledge regarding the possible side effects of biomarkers and checkpoint inhibitors dealing with the cardiovascular system. Both of these diseases, i.e. cancer and cardiovascular issues, share the same risk factor lineage. It could be anything between obesity, sedentary lifestyle, smoking, and chronic inflammation. According to present-day researches, it is the pre-existing cardiovascular disease in patients getting cancer therapies that cause high morbidity and mortality. Other risk factors of cardiotoxicity include dyslipidemia, hypertension, central adiposity, and metabolic syndrome. The median for both cancer and CVD is chronic inflammation, a 10-fold higher rate of CVD, and a 9-fold higher rate of stroke is reported in cancer survivors as compared to the general public. Out of all, the left ventricle function is the ground zero in patients getting cancer therapies because it impacts silently. We can hope that researchers could find out some solutions to resolve this issue, and cancer survivors can live a healthy life without any fear. On this note, this is Earthy Perks signing off. Till next time, stay tuned and keep watching Earthy Perks.